Hello, embedded systems lovers. Today, I'm going to guide you step by step on how you can draw schematic diagrams for any electronics or embedded systems project. I will show you how to draw schematic diagrams for two electronics projects as a case study, and I'm going to be using Proteus for drawing the schematic diagrams. A schematic diagram is like the blueprint of an electronic circuit. It shows the components and their connections using standard symbols, as you can see on screen. So a schematic diagram is different from a circuit diagram. A circuit diagram is also known as pictorial diagram and is different from schematic diagram. So we use schematic diagrams to help us understand, communicate, and troubleshoot our projects before we build them physically. Before we start, here are the steps we need to follow when designing any schematic diagram. First is to understand what project we are building. So understanding what you are building. Second is to identify the input, output, and the power that is going to be driving the project we are building. The third is to list out all the components by writing out all their symbols, all right? And then the fourth is to define the logic or the circuit flow, and lastly, to know where to start. To start learning how to draw the schematic diagram of any electronics project, our first project will be to draw a light-controlled LED using an LDR, light-dependent resistor, and a transistor. So the LED turns on when the room is dark, and the LED stays off when the room is bright. All right, you can see how the project works. So this is the problem. This is the project we want to draw the schematic. So first is to understand the purpose of this project. So in order to draw the schematic, here is the first step: understand the purpose of this project. So first is we want an LED that responds to light levels. After understanding the purpose of the light controlled LED, the next step is to identify the power that we're going to be using to drive the light controlled LED, and also to identify the input and the output, which is already represented on the block diagram on screen. So the power is a 9-volt battery, alright. The input is the LDR light dependent resistor to sense light and darkness, alright. Then the output is the LED that turns on or turns off, alright. So the power, which is a 9-volt battery, feeds both the input and the control part, which is going to be a transistor. So the input, the LDR, sends a signal to the control, which is a transistor. So, and then the transistor decides to allow current to flow to the output, which is the LED. So with a block diagram, you'll be able to represent your schematic diagram.
So guys, after defining your inputs, power, and output, the next step is to list out all the components you're going to be using to build or draw your schematic. So we'll need the 2N2 transistor that we're going to be using to control our output. We will need the LDR, which is the sensing device, and that's our input. So there are two LDR. The first one was the generic LDR, while this other one is the touch LDR. So with this, we can do a complete simulation on Proteus. Alright, then this is our transistor, 2N222 transistor, and this is our battery. We're going to be using the 9-volt battery. So, yeah, step 3, you list out all the components after you have factored step 2, which is the block diagram that consists of the clarification on the power, the input, and the output. So this next step is to list out all the components you're going to be using to draw your schematic diagram. So these are the various symbols of the components. this is the resistor, and you can see it's rectangular in shape. But for other simulation environments, it can be zigzag. All right, so either way, depending on the simulation environment you are using. So usually when drawing our schematic, we begin from the left hand side, starting with our power and moving over to our input. Alright, that's after knowing how to work with the input. And from our block diagram, we already know what's our input, and then we already know our output. Our step four is to define the logic for the project. And in this case, we need to understand voltage divider rule in order to build the light controlled LED project. So without understanding the voltage divider rule, we will not be able to work with the LDR in order to build the light controlled LED project. So previously I just showed you the formula for the voltage divider, and here is how the voltage divider schematic is connected. Now, the voltage divider rule, it's a simple circuit consisting of two resistors. Remember, the LDR, light dependent resistor, is also a resistor, but that one, the resistance depends on light. So when there is no light, it has a higher resistance, but when there is light, it has a lower resistance. But now, this is not an LDR circuit. There is no LDR in this circuit. This is just two resistors showing voltage divider. And a voltage divider circuit is an electronic circuit that shows two resistors that are connected in series, in such that the output of this connection gives a fraction of the input voltage. That's the essence of voltage divider, is so that when you connect two resistors in series, you can give an output voltage that is a fraction of the input voltage. So based on the values of the resistor used. So when you look at this voltage divider example, you will notice that you can see the voltmeter I used to measure the output voltage based on the variations of the R1 and the R2 resistor that is connected in this circuit. So when the R2, which is the resistor that is connected to the ground, when it's increased, you notice that the output voltage is closer to the input voltage, all right? But when R1, the resistor in R1, when it's higher than the R2, you realize that the output voltage was getting what? Lower in the voltmeter. So let's see what the output voltage would read now that we have reduced the R2. It's reading 31.9 millivolts, and that's very small compared to the 9 volts, which is our voltage source. So when R2 is higher, greater than R1, the output voltage becomes high, close to the initial input voltage. To draw the schematic, we're going to be using the Proteus software. And in drawing schematic diagrams, it's best we begin with the power supply and ensure that your power supply and the input begins from the left. So you begin your drawing from the left, starting with your input and the power supply. You make sure that the positive of the power supply is at the top and then the negative is at the bottom. All right. Then your output, in this case, the LED, should be at the right side. All right. So the LED and this resistor, this is a limiting resistor that is going to limit the flow of current entering this LED in order to protect the LED. It should be at the right. So your output devices are the right, and then your input and the power should be at the left. All right. So that's the best practice or a good practice in order to draw schematic diagrams. So this is the voltage divider of your LDR and a resistor. Like we said, the only way we can use this LDR for this light controlled LED is to use it in the form of a voltage divider. So now we are connecting our power. Remember, we said that the negative side of your power should be at the bottom and then the positive side should be at the top. So here we get to connect our voltage divider, that's R1 and R2, where the LDR is connected to R2. Alright, and now here is our transistor connected to the resistor. And remember what we said about the resistor. The resistor is just to limit the flow of current that is going to the LED. So one terminal of the resistor is connected to the collector. Why? Because the collector is usually connected to the load, which is the LED. Alright, that's how to use a transistor. So the base of the transistor, where the transistor gets biased, is connected to the output coming out from our voltage divider. And if you remember previously, our voltage divider, we connected the output to a voltmeter where we're reading the output voltage. Alright, and what happened in the previous example of a voltage divider was that when we vary the resistance of any of the resistor in R1 or R2, we get a corresponding output that is being read from our voltmeter. But in this case, we're going to be reading that output. We're not going to be reading it, but we're going to be using it to control the LED through a transistor. So we're using the touch LDR, alright? So here we can use an artificial or a simulated touch light to simulate when there is light and when there is darkness. Alright, so our previous example, when R2 is higher or greater than R1, that's resistor 1, the output is usually high, that is close to the input voltage used. But when R1 is higher than R2, then the output voltage is low. And remember, the LDR. Our second project is a digital circuit where we use two push buttons connected to an AND gate IC to control an LED. And our first step to achieve this is to understand the purpose of this project. And the purpose is that we want the LED to stay on if none of the push buttons are pressed. But the LED should stay off if any of the push buttons is pressed. Step two is to identify the power, the input, and the output. The power is a 5-volt power supply. Input are the two push buttons, and the output is the LED. Here are the components, the two switches, the AND gate IC, the LED, and the resistor. And here is the two switches for the input. And we begin our drawing from the left-hand side, starting with our input or our power supply. Alright, and here is our output, the LED, and the current limiting resistor as our output on the right hand side. And this is our AND gate IC that we're going to be using for the control logic. Alright, so here is the AND gate IC that we're going to be feeding the two switches to its input for us to get a corresponding output based on the AND logic gate operation. Alright, so here is the battery, 5-volt battery, since this is a digital circuit, so we use 5-volt battery. Of 5 volts, although we are not going to be using the battery in this simulation, because on Proteus, when working with the AND gate IC, which is 74LX08, it's already connected, it's already powered. So we are going to just connect our output, which is the LED and the limiting resistor, to the LED connected to the output of our AND gate IC in order to give response or lit up when signal is passed to any of the switches, that is when it's closed or open. So this is how we get to draw. So we said we start our drawing from the left and we connect our input. We start with our input devices at the left hand side and we put our output devices like LEDs and any other output devices like motor or speakers at the right hand side. So let's simulate and see how it works. So it's working the same way the live circuit before the simulation, the same way it works. So in its default state, the LED is on. All right, defaultly the output from the AND gate IC is high, but when any of the switches is pressed. Here is a recap to what we've learned so far. So the steps towards drawing a schematic diagrams include understanding what project you're working on or building. The two is map the power, the input and the output using a block diagram if possible. The third one is to list out all the components, which is list out all the symbols of all the components you are going to be using. And the fourth one is to define the logic flow. And the last one is to know where to start and carefully wire each part. So guys, if you found this guide helpful, like this video, subscribe for more tutorials, and let me know in the comments what project you would want me to cover next. Please click on the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you and bye-bye.